pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool. And when I finally got sober, felt 10 years.
Hi guys.
Okay.
Increase the tempo to 102 BPMs. The vocal chop is just feels like one vocal that kind of goes up and then goes back into like a normal vocal. At the end, we added a marimba. Hi guys, welcome back to another Beat Breakdown. Today we're gonna have a look at our remix of I Took a Pill in Ibiza. And without any further ado, let's dive right into it. This record was originally a ballad in 74 BPM, and Mike's vocal sounded like this.
I took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool.
So what we did, we increased the tempo to 102 BPMs. And we added some plugins to his vocals, some autotune, EQ, and this nice 2CBC reverb. And a little bit of sidechaining, another EQ just for some high end. And then this dynamic EQ just to, I think, just remove some of the S's, like a de-esser. And then it sounded like this.
I took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool.
And when it comes to the arrangement, as you can see here, it's pretty simple. You have in green there, you have the vocals. And beneath that, you have the drums. Under there again, you have the all the music. And at the end here, we have the FX. If you look at the music first, it's based around the two plugs, where the first one is a massive. You'll listen to it in solo. And it also goes through this music bus with a filter on it. So if you turn off the filter, you can hear how it is. And there's also a little bit of saturation on it. Just playing simple fifths without any thirds. So it's not either major or minor. So if you look at the MIDI here, it's only fifth notes. Very simple. And then it's dubbed with another plug, which is the Lush 101. And it doesn't play the same notes, little bits difference here and there. So if you listen to that in solo. So together they create some kind of nice melodies and harmonies. And yes, and as I said, on the music bus, we have some filter. So if I turn it back on again, as you can see in the arrangement, it's automated. So it goes up and up to create some more energy, like a simple, well-known DJ trick. And the third instrument is just a simple harp, just to create some kind of a counter rhythm to the syncopated pluck pattern. So you will listen to the harp in solo. Just a simple contact instrument. But together it creates a nice rhythm. Instead of just having some drums there to create this counter rhythm to the plugs, we use just a simple harp. And that's it. That's a very simple beginning of the song.
Beezer, to show Avicii I was cool. And when I finally got sober, felt 10 years old.
The next part, that comes in some drums.
But you don't wanna be high like me. Never really know why.
So very simple drums. It's a snap, and reverse snap on every four, I think. Yeah. So it was a loop that we just used some volume automation just to get those nice reversed effects on every second note. Just to make it a little bit more interesting. And we also added a bass. Super simple, just playing the root chords. And this is the bass plugin. It's an emulation of a classic Oberheim synth called the OBXA, I think. And as you can see in Ableton, we some EQ, sidechaining, another EQ, and R bass, just to give it a little bit more low end. And we also added a pad, just a simple pad from Nexus. Just playing the chords, very simple. And together it sounded like this. I like me, never really know why like me. You don't ever want to step off that roller coaster and be all alone. Yeah. And some crashes and sweeps. On the next part of the song, we build it up a little bit more, but again, very simple, just a loop. Nothing on it. Oh, I know. A sad soul. Sad. As you can see in the music folder, we have added some new instruments, and one of them is a flute. Which is dubbed with an octave under. Which creates some kind of nice kind of melody to the lead vocals. And here, as we did with the harp, we added a, it's a called Mbira. It's an, I think it's African thumb piano. And again, this creates both harmonic and melodic flavor to the song, but also nice rhythmical element. So it moves the track forward. If you just listen to the music in solo, it sounds like this. Together with the drums and the vocals. Oh, I know. Sad song, darling, oh. As you can hear, it's such a great song, and when the vocals are so good as they are, there's no need to use so many instruments and so many tracks, and I think that's why this arrangement is so simple. All right, and then we go into the next section of the song, which is a drop. Again, this is super simple. It's just a kick drum and some percussion from the verses, and that's it. And we have the drop melody, which is based around Mike's vocals. And if you listen to the sample in solo. Now turn off the plugins. I know. Yeah, that's how it is. As you can see in the sampler here, it's just the word I know, and but the know is stretched, so you can create this loop here. I know. And when you have the glide function on, and when that means that when you trigger a new note, it doesn't re-trigger the sample. So
I know.
This melody was really simple, just to play on the keyboard, and yeah, as you can see in the MIDI here, this was it. And here, when the notes don't start from the beginning again, then you have this nice melody that goes up here. And of course, it sounds a little bit better with some sidechaining, EQ, echo board, just a simple delay. And again, our beloved EOS reverb. And some sidechain on the reverb as well. And then it sounds like this. You can also see this nice detail on the EQ that we boosted the mid. Just get the melody out there. If you hear when it goes up. Otherwise it would just drown in the mix. So in the context of the music, it sounded like this. And then we added in the straight vocals. With the same processing, so it sounds like this one. The vocal chop just feels like one vocal. So it kind of goes up and then goes back into like a normal vocal. And apart from that, I think only added this extra piano. Just to give the song some more, like a more harmonic feeling. And again, it's just the Nexus, EQ, compression, a reverb from both Ableton and the same we used on the drop, the EOS. Sounds really nice. And of course, a couple of crashes and sweeps. That's it. And on the second part of the drop, we just added a little bit of a percussion, a loop. A little bit of the harp and the African thumb piano. And there's also this guitar here. It's kind of works with the thumb piano. And also the bass, it's just the bass from the verses, but now it plays just the root note of the plucks. Again, very simple, but very effective. And then we go back to the second verse, which is close to the first one.
Singer. Already blew his shot. I get along with old timers, cause my name's a reminder of a pop song people forgot.
And here you can see we used the filter freak on the music, like a simple trick, just to get the intensity down, you know, because the darker the sounds are, they're mellower and softer it feels. And you can see in Ableton, the automation here is just, yeah, it's climbing towards the next section of the song.
Like me, never really knowing why. Like me, you don't ever want to step off that roller coaster and be all alone.
At the end, we added a marimba just to dub the drop melody. And also the vocal chop, it goes through the same bus as the music, and as you can hear, it has this nice saturation on it. It's the plugin here from Ableton. And if I turn it off, you can hear without. And I turn it back on again. gives a little bit more crunch. It's a little bit. And before that, yeah, you have the simple sidechain. So everything is sidechained together. And all this music goes through the drums, and the music goes through this music bus, which has isotope 5. And listen to first how it sounds without. And then with. Kind of glues things very nicely together. And also we have a similar one on the master. And before that one we have the glue compressor. After that one you have the satin tape plugin. And I think just a simple EQ. After that again, and at the end, we use the Slate FGX limiter. And if you hear it on a lower level without, and with. Yeah, it sounds a little better. Yeah, and that's it. And if you guys have any questions, comments, feel free to use the comments field and ask whatever you want to ask. And if you like it, hit the like button. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.